Uno. No están funcionando. Doing okay. Let me check that the reading that you're reading is in the book. No están trabajando. Que no están trabajando.
De nosotros tampoco, che.
Folks, as you come outside, please walk to the sides of the fire. If our ministers of hospitality could help us out here. Folks who are coming out the doors, please come out and come to the sides, please. Leave some room for the people behind you to get outside as well. Thank you. Folks, if you could continue to step to the sides, please. There are still some more people coming out of the church. Please open up some doorways.
Por orden, dar salida por los que están todavía dentro.
because you're old.
Silencio, por favor. Please be quiet. We still have some need for some people to come out the doors. Dear brothers and sisters, on this most holy night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters scattered throughout the world to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Dios nuestro, que por medio de tu Hijo nos ha comunicado el fuego de tu vida divina, bendice este fuego nuevo y estas pascuales enciendan en nosotros el que podamos llegar con un espíritu a la fiesta gloriosa de tu reino. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Belongs to him. And all ages. Glory and power. Every age forever. And protect us. Amen. Amen. The taper to me. Thank you. Thank you. the darkness of our minds. Please process in silence into the church at this time, sitting in any seat that is not marked as reserved. In silencio.
Thank you.
please stand?
Exalt, let them exalt. the hosts of heaven exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt, let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad, as glory floods her, ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of His glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. En verdad es justo, es innecesario aclamar con nuestras voces y con todo el afecto del corazón a Dios invisible, el Padre Todopoderoso, y a su Hijo único, nuestro Señor Jesucristo, porque Él ha pagado por nosotros al Eterno Padre la deuda de Adán, y ha borrado con su sangre inmaculada la condena del antiguo pecado. Porque estas son las fiestas de Pascua, en las que se inmola el verdadero Cordero, cuya sangre consagra las puertas de los fieles. This is the night when once let our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to His holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. De que no serviría haber nacido si no hubiéramos sido rescatados. Qué asombrosa beneficio de tu amor por nosotros, qué incomparable ternura y caridad para rescatar al esclavo entregaste al hijo. Necesario fue el pecado de Adán, que ha sido borrado por la muerte de Cristo. Feliz la culpa que mereció tal Redentor. Qué noche tan dichosa, solo ella conoció el momento en que Cristo resucitó del abismo. Esta es la noche de la que estaba escrito. Será la noche clara como el día, la noche iluminada por mi gozo. Y así esta noche santa ayuda los pecados, lava las culpas, devuelve la inocencia a los caídos, la alegría a los tristes, expulsa el odio, trae la concordia, doblega los poderosos. On this your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor. A fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated and extinguish your tapers. At this time, we invite the ministers of hospitality to come forth with baskets to collect those tapers. Please passing your tapers to the end of the aisle. In silence, please. In silencio, por favor. My dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the Word of God. Let us meditate on how God, in times past, saved His people, and in these, the last days, has sent us His Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption. Oremos para que Dios nuestro Padre conduzca a su plenitud esta obra de salvación iniciada con la muerte y resurrección de Jesucristo.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in His image. In the image of God, He created him. Male and female, He created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and all the living things that move upon the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, and all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl upon the ground. I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything that he had made and found it very good. The word of the Lord.
Send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, you my God, you are great indeed. You have clothed with majesty and glory, robed in light as with a cloak. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. You fix the earth upon its foundation, not to be moved forever. With the ocean as with a garment you covered it. Above the mountains the water stood. Lord, send out your spirit. You sent for springs and the water courses, that a wind among the mountains, beside the birds of the heavens dwell. From among the branches they send forth their song.
Lord, send out your spirit.
How manifold your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Lord, send out.
Lectura del libro de Éxodo. En aquellos días dijo el Señor a Moisés, ¿por qué sigues clamando a mí? Diles a los israelitas que se pongan en marcha, y tú alza tu bastón, extiende tu mano sobre el mar y divídelo. Para que los israelitas entren en el mar sin mojarse. Yo voy a endurecer el corazón de los egipcios para que los persigan, y me cubriré de gloria a expensas del faraón y de todo su ejército, de sus carros y jinetes. Cuando me haya cubierto de gloria a expensas del faraón, de sus carros y jinetes, los egipcios sabrán que yo soy el Señor. El ángel del Señor que iba al frente de las huestes de Israel se colocó tras ellas, y la columna de nubes que iba adelante también se desplazó y se puso a sus espaldas entre el campamento de los israelitas y el campamento de los egipcios. La nube era tinieblas para unos y claridad para otros, y así los ejércitos no trabaron contacto durante toda la noche. Moisés extendió la mano sobre el mar, y el Señor hizo soplar durante toda la noche un fuerte viento del este que secó el mar y dividió las aguas, mientras las aguas formaban una muralla a su derecha y a su izquierda. Los egipcios se lanzaron en su persecución, y toda la caballería del faraón, sus carros y gente y jinetes entraron tras ellos en el mar. Hacia el amanecer, el Señor miró desde la columna de fuego y humo al ejército de los egipcios, y sembró entre ellos el pánico. Trabó las ruedas de sus carros, de suerte que no avanzaban sino pesadamente. Dijeron entonces los egipcios, Huyamos de Israel, de Israel, porque el Señor lucha en su favor contra Egipto. Entonces el Señor le dijo a Moisés, extiende tu mano sobre el mar para que vuelvan las aguas sobre los egipcios, sus carros y sus jinetes. Y extendió Moisés su mano sobre el mar, y al amanecer las aguas volvieron a su sitio, de suerte que al huir los egipcios se encontraron con ellas, y el Señor los derribó en medio del mar. Volvieron las aguas y cubrieron los carros y los jinetes y a todo el ejército del faraón que se había metido en el mar para perseguir a Israel. Ni uno solo se salvó. Pero los hijos de Israel caminaban por lo seco en medio del mar. Las aguas les hacía murala a derecha y es izquierda. Aquel día salvó el Señor a Israel de las manos de Egipto. Israel vio a los egipcios muertos en la orilla del mar. Israel vio la mano fuerte del Señor sobre los egipcios. Y el pueblo temió al Señor y creyó en el Señor y en Moisés, su siervo. Entonces Moisés y los hijos de Israel cantaron este cántico al Señor.
Cantemos al Señor, súbele su victoria. Cantemos al Señor, revestido de gloria. Cantemos al Señor, súbele su victoria. Cantemos al Señor, revestido de gloria.
Mi fuerza y mi poder es el Señor, Él fue mi salvación. Es mi Dios, yo lo alabaré. El Dios de mis padres, yo lo ensalzaré.
Cantemos al Señor, sublime es su victoria. Cantemos al Señor, revestido de gloria.
El Señor es un guerrero, los carros del faraón los lanzó al mar, arrojó en el mar a sus mejores capitanes.
Cantemos al Señor, sublime es su victoria. Cantemos al Señor, revestido de gloria.
Las olas los cubrieron, bajaron hasta el fondo como piedras. Tu diestra, Señor, es terrible, tritura al enemigo.
Y los plantas en el monte de tu heredad, del que hiciste tu trono, santuario, Señor, que fundaron tus manos, reinarás por siempre jamás.
Cantemos al Señor, sublime es su victoria.
Oremos. Dios nuestro, que manifestaste a la luz del Nuevo Testamento el sentido profundo de los prodigios realizados en los tiempos antiguos, dejándonos ver en el paso del Mar Rojo una imagen del bautismo y en el pueblo liberado de la esclavitud, un anuncio de los sacramentos del pueblo cristiano. Haz que todos los hombres, mediante la fe, participen del privilegio del pueblo elegido y sean regenerados por la acción santificadora de lo Espíritu. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén. Amén.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The one who has become your husband is your maker. His name is the Lord of hosts. Your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel, called God of all the earth. The Lord calls you back like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit. A wife married in youth and then cast off, says your God. For a brief moment, I abandoned you. But with great tenderness, I will take you back. In an outburst of wrath, for a moment, I hid my face from you. But with enduring love, I take pity on you, says the Lord your Redeemer. This is for me like the days of Noah, when I swore that the waters of Noah should never again deluge the earth. So I have sworn not to be angry with you or to rebuke you. Though the mountains leave their place and the hills be shaken, my love shall never leave you, nor my covenant of peace be shaken, says the Lord, who has mercy on you. O afflicted one, storm-battered and unconsoled, I lay your pavements in carnelians and your foundations in sapphire. I'll make your battlements of rubies, your gates of carbuncles, and all your walls of precious stones. All your children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the peace of your children. In justice shall you be established, far from the fear of oppression, where destruction cannot come near you. The word of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me and have not let your enemies rejoice over me. Oh, Lord, you have raised my soul from the dead. Restore me to life.
listened and had pity. The Lord came to my help, for me you have changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, I will thank you.
Almighty ever-living God, surpass for the honor of your name what you pledged to the patriarchs by reason of their faith and through sacred adoption. Increase the children of your promise so that what the saints of old never doubted would come to pass, your church may now see in great part fulfilled. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Lectura del libro del profeta Isaías. Así dice el Señor: todos los sedientos vengan por agua. Ustedes que no tienen dinero, vengan y tomen grano y coman. Vengan sin pagar y sin costo. Beban vino y leche. ¿Por qué gastar tu dinero en lo que no es pan y tu salario en lo que no te satisface? Escúchenme y coman bien, deleítense con abundancia. Vengan a mí con atención, escuchen para que tengan vida. Renovaré con ustedes un pacto eterno, los beneficios asegurados a David, como yo lo hice testigo a los pueblos. Jefe y comandante de las naciones, así convocarás a una nación que no conocías, y las naciones que no te conocieron correrán a ti por causa del Señor tu Dios, el Santo de Israel que te ha glorificado. Busquen al Señor mientras pueda ser hallado, llámenlo mientras está cerca. Que el sinvergüenza abandone su camino y el malvado sus pensamientos. Que se vuelva al Señor en busca de misericordia, a nuestro Dios que es generoso en perdonar, porque mis pensamientos no son sus pensamientos, ni vuestros caminos son mis caminos. Así dice el Señor: tan altos como los cielos están por encima de la tierra, así de altos son mis caminos, por encima de sus caminos, y mis pensamientos por encima de sus pensamientos. Porque así como del cielo desciende la lluvia y la nieve y no vuelven allí, hasta que hayan regado la tierra, haciéndola fértil y frutífera, dando semilla al que siembra y pan al que come, así será mi palabra que sale de mi boca. Mi palabra no volverá a mí vacía, sino que hará mi voluntad, logrando el fin para el cual lo envié. Palabra del Señor.
Y sacarán agua con alegría de las fuentes de la salvación. Y sacarán agua con alegría de las fuentes de la salvación. Vean cómo es Él, el Dios que me salva.
me siento seguro y sin miedo, porque Él es mi fuerza y mi canción. Él es el Señor, mi alegría, Él es mi salvación. Y sacarán la agua con alegría de las fuerzas de la salvación. Y sacarán la agua con alegría de las fuerzas de la salvación. Denle gracias al Señor, victor en su nombre santo. Publiquen a los pueblos sus hazañas, proclamen el nombre del Señor.
Y sacarán la agua de una alegría de las fuentes de la salvación. Y sacarán la agua con alegría de las fuentes de la salvación.
Canten al Señor porque ha hecho maravillas que toda la tierra debe conocer. Griten de contento y alegría, habitantes de Sion, porque grande se ha portado conmigo el Santo de Israel. Y sacará
Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, única esperanza del mundo, que por la predicación de tus profetas desvelaste los misterios de esta era presente, aumenta bondadosamente el anhelo de tu pueblo, porque solo a instancias de tu gracia los fieles progresan en cualquier tipo de actividad de virtud. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén. Amén.
Atiende nuestra súplica, tú que
estás sentado a la derecha, a la derecha.
Pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that, renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If, then, we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. The house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live, declare the works of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord his has been done, he is wonderful in our eyes.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right-hand side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He's not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he has told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
So glad we bought a new air conditioning system. Doesn't it feel great in here tonight? C.S. Lewis is a favorite author of mine. His ability to capture the essence of the human experience is a testament to the wisdom contained within his novels, as well as his nonfiction. If you've yet to read any of his works, put any of them on your to-read list. One of his works, published in the mid-1950s, is entitled Surprised by Joy. The title originally, a poem written by William Wadsworth about the death of his daughter. Lewis used some of the same imagery in the poem to describe his early life and conversion to Christianity. He notes that true joy, different from happiness or pleasure, often comes to us as a, quote, stab, a pang, an inconsolable longing. Truly, pure joy can explode in our lives with the power of a thunderbolt that goes to the core of our being. No other experience can give witness to the presence of God like joy. Interestingly, late in Lewis's life, after years as a bachelor, he married an American poet named Joy Gresham. Many have commented that he was truly surprised by joy. For what have we come here this evening? Are we looking for some comfort from the challenges of our everyday lives? Are we looking for a respite of pleasure in a world that is torn by pain and dysfunction? Will our deepest desires be met by either of these? Or might we consider this night is made for something more profound, more explosive, more radiant? We come here tonight to glance into the empty tomb and be surprised by joy. Our lives will never be the same. Jesus desires to transform our lives, not for a moment, but for an eternity. And so, our response to the empty tomb needs to be more than just a momentary pleasure or happy thought. Our response needs to be as profound as the resurrection of Jesus, that tonight is more like a stab of joy that fills our otherwise inconsolable longing. A large number of us will be baptized, confirmed, and receive the Eucharist for the first time. Tonight, may you be surprised by joy as the grace of these sacraments, which many lifelong Catholics take so much for granted, pierce deeply into your hearts and minds to remind you and us that God so loved each and every one of us to share his resurrected life with us
in these special sacraments. The empty tomb is the purest of joy. May we all let the world know. Let the world know about this great joy. May we let them know about it as they see that in the way we live every single day. Maybe they too will be surprised by joy. C.S. Lewis es uno de mis autores favoritos. Su capacidad para capturar la esencia de la experiencia humana es un testimonio de la sabiduría contenida en sus novelas, así como en su obra de non ficción. Si aún no has leído alguna de sus obras, pon alguna de ellas en tu lista de lecturas. Una de sus obras publicadas a mediados de la década de 1950 se titula Cautivado por la Alegría. El título originalmente era un poema escrito por William Wordsworth sobre la muerte de su hija. Lewis usó algunos de las mismas imágenes en el poema para describir sus primeros años de vida y conversión al cristianismo. Señala que la verdadera alegría, a diferencia de la felicidad o el placer, a menudo nos llega como una puñalada, una punzada, un anhelo inconsolable. En verdad, la alegría pura puede estallar en nuestras vidas con el poder de un rayo que llega hasta lo más profundo de nuestro ser. ¿Conocen otras experiencias que puedan dar testimonio de la presencia de Dios como la alegría? Curiosamente, al final de la vida de Lewis, después de años como soltero, se casó con una poetisa estadounidense llamada Joy Gresham, Joy, Alegría. Muchos han comentado que estaba realmente cautivado por Joy, por Alegría. ¿Para qué hemos venido aquí esta noche? ¿Estamos buscando algo de consuelo ante los desafíos de nuestra vida cotidiana? ¿Estamos buscando un respiro de placer en un mundo desgarrado por el dolor y la disfunción? Cualquiera de estos logrará satisfacer nuestros deseos más profundos. O podríamos considerar que esta noche está hecha para algo más profundo, más explosivo, más radiante. Hemos venido que esta noche para echar un vistazo a la tumba vacía y ser cautivados por la alegría. Nuestras vidas nunca volverán a ser las mismas. Jesús desea transformar nuestras vidas no por un momento, sino por una eternidad. Por lo tanto, nuestra respuesta a la tumba vacía debe ser algo más que un placer momentáneo o un pensamiento feliz. Nuestra respuesta debe ser tan profunda como la resurrección de Jesús, que esta noche es más como una puñalada de gozo que llena nuestro anhelo, que de otro modo sería inconsolable. Un gran número de nosotros seremos bautizados, confirmados, y recibiremos la Eucaristía por primera vez esta noche. Que puedan ser cautivados por la alegría a medida que la gracia de estos sacramentos, que muchos católicos de toda la vida dan por sentado, penetre profundamente en sus corazones y mentes para recordarles a ustedes y a nosotros que Dios nos amó tanto a cada uno de nosotros para compartir su vida resucitada con nosotros en estos sacramentos especiales. La tumba vacía es el gozo más puro. Que todos se lo hagamos saber al mundo, a verlo en la forma en que vivimos todos los días. Quizás ellos también se sientan cautivados por la alegría. Amén.
Geneva, Adekambe. Giovanni, Adekambe. Angelie, Cameron. Angelina Cameron. Angeline Cameron. Carly Diaz. Margie Diaz Sorto. Malin Diaz Sorto. Randy Diaz Sorto. Gloria Gugino. Vanessa Gogino. Dylan Hernandez. Carla Hernandez. Oscar Hernandez. Betty Marquez Portillo. Brian Marquez Portillo. Alessandra Ortega. Christian Ortega. Isabella Ortega. Kehlani Venegas Gallegos. Jesus Villalobos Cruz. Terry Lee Hanner. Shakira Denise Smith. Nam Huang Ho. Clemente Delgadillo Lopez.
Dearly beloved, with one heart and one soul, let us by our prayers come to the aid of these, our brothers and sisters, in their blessed hope, so that as they approach the font of rebirth, the Almighty Father may bestow on them all his merciful help.
Kneel, please. De rodillas todos.
Lord, have mercy.
Cristo, ten piedad.
Lord, have mercy.
Santa María, Madre de Dios.
Ruega por nosotros.
San Miguel.
Ruega por nosotros. Ruega por nosotros.
San Juan Bautista.
Ruega por nosotros.
San José.
Ruega por nosotros.
San Pedro y San Pablo.
Ruega por nosotros.
San Andrés.
Ruega por nosotros.
San Juan.
Ruega por nosotros. Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch. such was Saint Felicity.
Pray for us.
Saint Agnes.
Derrama, Señor, tu infinita bondad en este sacramento del bautismo y envía a tu Santo Espíritu para que haga renacer de la fuente bautismal a estos nuevos hijos tuyos que van a ser santificados por tu gracia mediante la colaboración de nuestro ministerio. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
Amén. O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit is in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people set free from slavery to Pharaoh would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection, commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit."
Amen.
Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature, created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old, may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please respond to our elect, I say. Please respond, I do, to the following. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Geneva, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Geneva, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We'll be applauding a lot. Maybe we should wait until the last one and then we'll applaud all together, if that's okay. Giovanni, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Giovanni, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Angeline, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Angeline, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Angelina, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Angelina, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Angeline, do you wish to be baptized in the life of Christ?
I do.
Angeline, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Carlos, do you wish to be baptized in the life of Christ? Carlos, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Margie, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Margie, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Malin, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Malin, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Randy, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Randy, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Gloria, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Gloria, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Vanessa, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Vanessa, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Dylan, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Dylan, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Carla, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Carla, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Oscar, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Oscar, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Betty, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Betty, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Brian, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Brian, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Alessandra, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Alessandra, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christian, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Christian, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Take it back. Sorry, take that with you. Isabella, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Isabella, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Here you go. Here you go. Kalani, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Kalani, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Jesus, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Jesus, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Terry, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Terry, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shakira, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ?
I do.
Shakira, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Nam, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Nam, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Clemente, do you wish to be baptized into the life of Christ? Clemente, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My sisters and brothers, you've been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as children of the light, and keep the flame of faith alive in your hearts. When the Lord comes, may you go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, all of us have been reborn, buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may rise with him to newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. Por eso, después de haber terminado el tiempo de Cuaresma que nos prepara para la Pascua, es muy conveniente que renovemos las promesas de nuestro bautismo. Please respond with either of the following, I do or si renuncio. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? ¿Creen ustedes en Dios, Padre Todopoderoso, Creador del cielo y de la tierra? ¿Creen en Jesucristo, su Hijo único y Señor nuestro, que nació de la Virgen María, padeció y murió por nosotros, resucitó y está sentado a la derecha del Padre? ¿Creen en el Espíritu Santo, en la Santa Iglesia Católica, en la comunión de los santos, en el perdón de los pecados, en la resurrección de los muertos, y en la vida eterna?
Amen.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand.
Mercy, heal us with your power.
Alexia Perez Venancio. Francisco Venegas Gallegos.
My dear friends, of your own free will, you have asked to be received into the full communion of the Catholic Church. You've made your decision after careful thought under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I now invite you, in the presence of this community, to profess the Catholic faith. In this faith, you will be one with us for the first time at the Eucharistic table of the Lord Jesus, the sign of the Church's unity. My dear friends, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that you have professed in the presence of his family. My dear brothers and sisters, in baptism you have become members of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them and their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, will make you more like Christ and help you to be witnesses to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and love. My dear friends, let us pray to God our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on these candidates for confirmation, to strengthen them with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God.
Dios Todopoderoso, Padre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, que has hecho nacer de nuevo a estos hijos tuyos por medio del agua y del Espíritu Santo, librándolos del pecado, escucha nuestra oración y envía sobre ellos tu Espíritu Santo Consolador, Espíritu de sabiduría y de inteligencia, Espíritu de consejo y de fortaleza, Espíritu de ciencia, de piedad y de tu santo temor, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amén.
Thank you.
My dear brothers and sisters, the day has come at last when you will join us around the Lord's table. Please be seated as we prepare for the Eucharistic feast and know by our applause that we love and affirm you and ensure you of our support. Seated. Please stand. On this sacred night, let us pray that the resurrection of Christ will touch, heal, and strengthen all who are in need.
For La Iglesia, for the Church of God gathered in Easter joy throughout the world, that even in times of sin and disappointment, we will never forget the central truth of our faith celebrated this day, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, for todos aquellos confiados con el liderazgo de las naciones, que la paz reine en sus mentes y en sus corazones, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por los recién bautizados y confirmados, for the newly baptized and confirmed, especially members of our parish community, that throughout the coming 50 days of Easter, they will rejoice in their newness of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, por aquellos que se reunirán con sus familias este día, que las celebraciones se marquen por la reconciliación y gozo verdadero en el Cristo resucitado, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por los enfermos, that the healing love of the Spirit will touch them, strengthen them, and bring them to wholeness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por los fieles difuntos, that Jesus, who is the resurrection and the life, may welcome them into God's presence and peace forever, we pray.
God, our Creator, hear the prayers of your people who bask in the glow of this holiest of night. Give strength and courage to all who suffer. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. There is a second collection tonight for the seminarians of the Archdiocese of Atlanta. We thank you for your generosity.
Darkness veiled the sky the day that Jesus died in agony upon a bitter cross. They took his body down and laid it in a tomb. His friends believed that everything was lost. But when the third day came and darkness turns to light, Mary heard her name and saw the living Christ risen to set the
broken heart, conquer death and sin, risen to bring us home again.
And in that barren place, the world forever changed, where hope was born when Jesus rose and paid.
And still his wounded hands reveal the love he has for every fallen soul.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the grace and glory of his name, for our good and all his church.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Yeah.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout all the world, and bring her to the fullness of unity and charity, together with our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Friar Archbishop Gregory John, with his assistants Joel, Bernard, and John, with all the bishops, with all the men and women who seek to serve you by serving your people.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, let me
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours forever. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Come on up.
blessed are we, blessed to be called, called to the supper of the Lamb. A sacrifice renewed with Christ is our feast, our promise of the glory to come. Blessed are we, blessed to be called, called to the supper of the Lamb. His sacrifice renewed, and Christ as our feast, our promises of glory to come. To the Lamb's own feast we come, clothed in Christ, baptized in water. Spirit's grace will lead us home to the banquet here rewarded. Sing to Christ on high and the supper of the Lamb.
His sacrifice we bear, his Christ is our feast, our promise of the glory to come. To his purpose shall we sing, hear his holy body sing, hear his words
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this paschal sacrament one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
There are so many. What a blessing tonight has been that all of us have come and kept vigil to be in a particular way present to our 27 newest members of our community. So happy for them and for us. Join me again. Congratulations. So much of this night is the result of so many people who give of themselves so generously throughout the course of the year. Certainly, our catechists who have been walking with all of these folks for a long time, our liturgical ministers who do so much to make our celebration so wonderful, those who make the place beautiful, those who work behind the scenes in the sacristy, those who are up here fulfilling some other ministry, and certainly our music ministry that just works so hard to make tonight's celebration a blessing. For all of those folks, let us give our thanks to them. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.